They used to say, the children used to say, I don't know what you come to do.
Yeah, but I come
to praise his name. I come to clap my hand. Come on, clap your hand. Come on. Get that. Amen. Come on. I came to clap my hand. I came to pat my feet. But you got to know where you are. Because if you're in a club, don't they pat? Come on here and help me. But you're not in a club. You're in the church of the living God. And you ought to clap your hands. You ought to pat your feet. You ought to shout. See, I'm scared. I'm scared of this new religion. I'm scared of these folk. I'm scared of them because when I was growing up, right here in Bella Vista, on that side, you didn't have to tell folk to shout.
Come on.
You didn't have to tell them it's your turn.
Yeah.
Amen. They'd get up and they began to shout. They'd shout. Sister Barry would shout and shout. And she would shout at a place and then began to walk all around the church. And she just shouted. She's just shouting. Are you listening to me? We're too sophisticated. We're too educated. We don't want nobody to know that God's been good to me. When I think about all his goodness and all he's done for me, my soul. My soul, even if I want to act dignified, my soul says, say something. Now, I'm just about through, amen, but you need to understand that if you've been reconciled with God, then you have peace. You have peace with God. Now, the trouble is, that people don't have peace with God. And sin will always cause you to be confused and cause you to be unhappy and cause you to be miserable because you need to see God and his goodness to you at all times. And the Bible says, first of all, what does the blood mean? And that's right here in the scripture. That the blood means that God's been good to you. Even when you didn't know it, he was good to you. And then secondly, what the blood has done to secure you, not only in this time, but in the world to come. I just want people, everybody, to know the Lord and serve the Lord. But it's your choice. You have to make your choice to love God and serve God. I'm glad that he's been my shepherd. I'm glad that he's been my friend. The blood of his cross must be distinguished from all other blood that was on the cross. There were some thieves that were on the cross that had a whole lot of blood. But it didn't mean anything. It didn't say for not a one of our sins. They were messed up. They were getting what they deserved. And they ought to had it. But there was a man that was in the middle. And his blood has made me whole. His blood has washed me. His blood has cleansed me. His blood has put me in the family of God. His blood helps me to hear his voice. And his voice, we ought to obey. Now I got to close, but I got to tell you, this one thing, before I go to my seat, I got to tell you this. You better get in touch with him and line up with his church before it's everlasting too late. You need to know, and the world needs to know, that if you forsake him on this side, he'll forsake you on the other side. You've got to understand that people are leaving here. Old folk leaving, young folk leaving, rich folk leaving, poor folk leaving, Elizabeth Taylor leaving, Marvin Zeller leaving, everybody leaving. But when the earthly house of this tabernacle is dissolved, those who are saved and washed in the blood shall be with our Heavenly Father. Now let me tell you, as I go to my seat, that there is nothing like sin. Let me tell you that sin includes everything that displeases God. Can I tell you about sin? Sin encompasses everything that rejects God and God's word and God's way. Sin is disgusting. Sin is dangerous. Sin is deceiving. Sin is devastating. Sin is dreadful. Sin is dominating. Sin is damning. Sin will mess you up all the time. You're in this world and you'll be messed up in the next world. You've got to understand, as I preach to you this morning, that there is nothing that can separate you from God except sin. You've got to understand that you can get rid of sin. There is a man called Jesus. You can get rid of sin. You want to get rid of sin. Now, I heard you this morning. I heard somebody as they began to sing. And I've been singing it for a long time. I've asked a question. What? If it's damning, if it's dangerous, if it's deceiving, if it's going to mess me up, not only in this world, but in the world to come, my greatest question and your greatest question is what can wash away my sin? I was born in sin. I was shaped in iniquity. I've sinned like everybody else. I got a record. I got a record. I should be on death row. But I one day gave myself to the Lord Jesus Christ. One day I fell down on my knees and said, I need you, Lord, in my life. And I ask you to take away my sin. And I want to tell you this morning, what can wash away your sin? What can wash away your sin? Your past sin. What can wash away your sin? Your present sin. What can wash away your sin? Your future sin. I gotta tell you, nothing. I gotta tell you, nothing. I've got to tell you, nothing but the blood, 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 but the blood. Wash me in that blood. Oh, precious is the fountain that makes me whiter than snow. No other help I know but Jesus the Christ, the Son of a living God. It can cleanse me. It can purge me. It can purge you You need to be there. Because there is a fountain. It's not a speck. It's a fountain that's filled with blood drawn from Emmanuel's veins and sinner's flow. You're looking at one. A sinner's flesh beneath the flood. Lose all. Do you want to get rid of your sins? Plunge beneath the flood. Can there anybody here that can say, truly say, I'm under the blood. I'm under the blood. Is there anybody that can truly say, the blood has signed my name? Say yes. Say yes. Say yes. Raise your hand. Are you saved? Get up on your feet. I'm under the blood. Yeah. 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 Say yes. Say yes. Say yes. Say yes. Say yes. I'm under the blood. Well, you sung it this morning. Down at the cross where my Savior died. Down there from sin I cried. There to my heart was the blood applied. And every day, I say glory. I lift my hand. I say glory. I pat my feet. I say glory. I dance around. I say glory. I say glory. I say glory to his name. I get excited. I get enthused. I get inspired because he's coming back for me. Is there anybody here that know the law? Are you so not saved? Are you so not saved? Say yes. I'm trying to quit. But every time I try, the wheel began to turn. The fire began to burn. Now, is he all right? Is he all right? Is he all right? Is he all right? Say yeah. Say yeah. Say yeah. Oh, yeah. 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 Hey. Yeah. Hey. Hey. The old folks used to say, glory, glory. Hallelujah. Since I lived, burden. Glory, glory. Hallelujah.
Since I lay burdened down. Do you know that? Do you not? All my troubles will be over. When I lay my burden down. All my troubles will be over. Since I laid my burden down,